Happy Friday, folks, and welcome to WatchGuard Security Week in Review, a video podcast dedicated to quickly summarizing the biggest information and network security stories each week and to sharing some practical security advice along the way. I'm your host and all-around security aficionado, Corey Nachreiner, and this is the episode for the week starting September 22nd, 2014. Now, typically, I share three security stories every week, and there's plenty of stories to pick from this week. However, I'm going to change it up a bit. There's actually only one very important security story that everyone needs to be aware of, and that's the story about ShellShock. Unless you've been in a cave over the past week, you've probably seen a number of stories about a big security flaw in something called Bash, or Born Again Shell. This is the command line shell that you use to interact with most Nix machines, so Linux or Unix machines, including even OS X machines, which happen to be based on BSD, so they have Bash shells as well. In any case, this is a very big vulnerability. A lot of people are saying it's bigger than a Heartbleed. They're panicking about it. They're saying you can take over all the Macs or all the computers in the world. This is a very important vulnerability, but I don't think it's anything to panic about. So let's talk about it first. If you haven't heard of Bash, again, this is the command line interface that pretty much ubiquitously ships with most Linux or Unix installs out there. And this is a pretty serious and easy to exploit vulnerability. For the organizations that rate vulnerabilities, they all give it a severity of 10, the highest severity rating. And that's because it's very, very easy to exploit. Basically, it has to do with how Bash shells process environmental variables. Basically, when you're creating a Bash script, you can have environmental variables. However, there's a flaw in the way that Bash processes them that allows attackers to put code injection. They can basically add another shell command that will execute with root privileges on the system. So it's very, very easy. Even if you're an unprivileged user that can open up a shell on a Linux machine, you can easily execute any code with full root privileges. Now, the second problem is, as you probably know, Bash or shells are local things. They're something you usually have when you locally log on to a computer. So how is this remotely exploitable? It's really not going to be that big a deal if it's not remotely exploitable. However, it is. The thing is, many of Linux's services use Bash shell. For instance, Apache has the ability for people to create websites that have CGI scripts, and CGI scripts use Bash shell. OpenSSH, in some cases, is compiled with something called force command, and if that's the case, you might be able to use OpenSSH connections to execute Bash shells. And even DHCP could be vulnerable. In many cases, DHCP servers have a place where they can actually execute environment variables, and you can inject some code so that any computer that connects to your DHCP server to get an address has code executed as root. So there are remote ways to actually exploit this Bash vulnerability, which makes it even a bigger deal. You know, there's tons of Apache servers on the network. In fact, already honeypots have seen that bad guys, now that they've seen how easy this vulnerability is to actually scan for, they're actually exploiting it. Many honeypots are picking up people using port 80 to see if there's vulnerable Apache servers, and there's even a botnet that's gotten victims using this Bash shell, and the botnet seems to be associated with some DDoS attacks. So this is a big vulnerability. The next question is what to do about it. Well, if you're a Linux user, obviously you need to update Bash. You know, any major Linux distro will have an update for this vulnerability. In fact, there's also, you know, distros like Ubuntu that will automatically update for this vulnerability. That said, it turns out that many of the first updates for this vulnerability, like the first Ubuntu update, wasn't good enough. It didn't completely close this hole. So you have to make sure that you're getting the latest update, the second update for this particular flaw. The harder problem, by the way, is really the embedded system issue, the fact that there's this Internet of Things. There's probably thousands of devices, IP cameras, personal NAS storage devices, all kinds of little things that are really embedded computers that you plug into your network that you don't realize are running Linux and may have Bash installed. Now, just because they have Bash installed won't immediately mean they're remotely vulnerable. They they have to somehow expose the bash shell to remote people, whether it be via Telnet or Apache or some of the other things I've mentioned. But there's going to be a huge amount of other Internet of Things devices that you also need to go out there and patch. So this is a really big vulnerability. If you use Unix systems or Linux systems, you have to go out and get the right patch as soon as you can. If you're a Mac user like I am, unfortunately Macs are vulnerable to this, and Apple hasn't quite released a vulnerability fix for this. That said, by default, most Mac computers don't expose any remote services that will give bad guys access to this vulnerability. So for the most part, they may be safe. The only possibility might be with malicious DHCP servers. I'm not sure how a Mac's DHCP client works, but it has been proven that, at least on Linux machines, you can use malicious DHCP servers to exploit this flaw. So that means if you connect to a Wi-Fi network and maybe has a malicious DHCP server on it, a Mac might be affected. So if you're a Mac user, keep your eye out for a patch coming up soon. Finally, if you're a WatchGuard customer out there, you might be wondering if any of our products are affected. You know, we do use a very hardened, customized Linux kernel in all our products. The good news is none of our security appliances are affected. You know, I never get much of an opportunity to talk about how WatchGuard focuses on using a hardened, custom security version of Linux. You know, we compile our own kernel, and we do a good job of removing all unnecessary packages. There's no reason we should have a shell running on our firewall. So shells like Bash or even any other shells like that are not installed on our firewall. So there's nothing there for these bad guys to exploit. And that goes the same for our mail security appliances, which is a BSD device, and for our SSL appliances as well. So there is no shell on any of our security appliances by default. You aren't vulnerable to this. I will mention, by the way, we also do have a debug firmware, which most of you will never run, but support sometimes runs on appliances. Even that is not vulnerable. That particular debug version does have a shell included in it for debugging purposes, but we don't use Bash. We use a different shell for that. So those aren't vulnerable. All that said, there's actually one product that is semi-affected by this bash vulnerability, and that's Dimension. Dimensions are a big visibility and analytics tool, which we deliver as a virtual machine. And it's actually a variant of Ubuntu. It's an Ubuntu server with a lot of services running. Dimension does have bash on it. That said, Dimension doesn't expose any sort of services that allow you access to this bash flaw. Furthermore, our Dimension install, for security reasons, automatically goes to Ubuntu.com to get the latest updates. So it's already patched itself once for this flaw, and if they have already released the second patch, the better patch for this, it will get that as well. So the only product that's somewhat affected is Dimension. However, we don't expose Bash in any way remotely, and it will automatically get any patch that's updated for it. The final thing I do want to mention is if you are an XDM appliance owner, our IPS service does have a signature for this vulnerability, so we can protect your network from people trying to exploit this vulnerability. So if you don't update your IPS automatically, you better go get the update immediately. And if you put that IPS update on your XDM appliance, we can prevent people from scanning your network looking for vulnerable devices. Well, that's it for this week. This ShellShock story is really probably the biggest deal of the week, but don't panic about it. Just go patch all your Unix and Linux systems, watch for an OS X patch, and make sure if you have any Internet of Things devices that you update those firmwares as they come out as well. Thank you very much for watching. As always, if you want more information from WatchGuard, check out the WatchGuard Security Center blog. You can follow me on Twitter, I'm at SecAdept, or follow WatchGuard at WatchGuard Tech. Thank you for watching, and here at WatchGuard, we're rooting for you.